Hello guys, welcome back to another episode of Hydroneer. It's Halloween season. These look amazing. There's an update that just came out today. The developer has put in pumpkins. So if we come to the shop over here, I believe it in every shop you can buy these jack-o'-lanterns right here. 160. Man, doesn't that look cool? But today is probably gonna be our last day on this plot over here. I want to go over and look at a couple of more of the logistics systems, set them up real quick, because I'm pretty sure I set this one up wrong, because when the durability of this machine hit zero, it automatically shot all of the spanners into the machine, but it wasn't actually repairing. Yeah, I'm gonna have to figure out a better way to wire this, and I do want to take a trip down to the shop area. When I started the episode, I was carrying the safe and I forgot to show you. These are all the ingots that I had just kind of laying around. We piled them up and we're gonna get 44,000. Pile up our money or throw it away. 116,000. I think that is the most we've ever had so far. Oh, I like that pumpkin up here on the bridge. That's a good spot for him. Got some pumpkins in the dinosaur eyes. I love it. Are there any special Halloween decorations other than the pumpkins? I don't believe so. The Hobson Power Works, that's right. Oh, and I have a little bit more here. Nice, 120,000. But today I wanted to look at this logic smelter powered intake pipe. Interesting. It is really dark now. You're probably not gonna be able to see very much. All right, 18,000. All right, because yeah, all of these are powered. They're very, very expensive. All right, let's go ahead. Let's just get the reactor. I don't quite know how I'm going to set this up yet, but we're just going to grab stuff. The powered David. I do want to experiment with that in the future, but not quite yet. All right, we're going to grab one of these. It might be a little easier to clean up our area with that. And yeah, that's a lot. 32,000. I think there's one more machine over in that other area that I want to take a look at. It was this one, the compressor. We are heading back. Okay, so now, can I just empty out everything into the wagon here? Maybe not. Probably, maybe just the small things.
Huh?
Alright, so our reactor, let's go ahead and just place it right here for now. Alright, so how does this work? So if I take this super laggy pan, can I just drop it in there just like that? I don't believe so. Now can I just dump everything in there? Uh-oh. Oh no. The true popcorn machine. Very quick. Can I pull the lever? I think that turned a gold piece. Maybe it didn't turn a gold piece. That could have just fallen into a pan. Yeah, this place is getting super, super laggy. Drop you in there. Very cool. Alright, so let's figure out this guy right here. The reactor here. So I need water going in that side. It's like nothing is happening. So now what do we do with this? I'm not sure if we have to stick the battery in here. I'm gonna assume no. This may just be a temporary, or maybe you can charge the batteries using this. Maybe it has to be in a shard. Okay, I think I hear something. Oh, look at that. Okay. If I open this, okay, now let's try putting the ingot in. Now that I have water going through it, I hear something, but I don't know if it's doing anything. Okay, so now this battery has a charge in it. Okay. Okay, so if I turn it on, it's gonna work. How long will those couple shards power this thing for? So it just completely destroys everything. It's a perfect cleanup tool. It looks like this is powering it for a little while. Okay, so now we know what that does. We're gonna go ahead, a powered magnet. So it doesn't look like there's any interface where you can decide what it's gonna pick up. Just gonna grab a couple of these off the front here. All right, we're gonna see if it grabs it from like two blocks diagonally. If it's two blocks straight ahead. A gem and another piece of gold. So I'm assuming it's just gonna pick up everything, but I kinda wanna see just in case. All right, I'm gonna go ahead and turn it on. So it only picks up two blocks in front of it. It does not pull from the side at all. Okay, well it is now. Place it there. Okay, it kind of pulled it in. So it looks like it's really close. That might be too far. We still have a little bit of charge. Okay, so it looks like if any part of your item is within this two block area, it picks it up. It would be nice to be able to have the magnet. Let's say if I stopped the line and I had a backup of stuff right here. I could power the magnet, have it pull it off the line, and then drop it down somewhere. This is the logic smelter. It requires a logic input to create the bar. Let's see, so this is the power. That's the power side and the logic side. Let's go ahead and sleep again. Alright, hopefully I'll be able to have enough charge for this. Okay, now I need just one of the logic ones. I think right there. Alright, so how does this work? Though this needs a logic input though. So this might just do it just automatically. So I'm gonna scoot it out one. Let's go ahead. If I place the T. Alright, so I placed that there. Let's go ahead and put piece of gold in there. Alright, we turn it on. This powers up nicely. Now if I push that. Oh, okay, so it just takes a while for it to melt on top. Now I can create the bar. It automatically spits it out. That is amazing. This is a fantastic machine. Alright, so that gave us one gold bar. And that one gold bar is worth six. Alright, it is now the next day for me. We have moved everything over to the South Hope plot. I have taken quite a bit of time to move everything over here. I have a whole bunch of power lines in this wheelbarrow, a whole bunch of pipes over here, a couple of just logic cables right there. I ran just a normal pipe out from the water back on the end over here. I bought a whole bunch of different machines, some more conveyor belts. Yeah, we're starting to set things up over here. Alright, so we are going to be using the Davids for this build over here, and we are going to do a design kind of like this with the logistic pipes. We're going to have our detector on the top with the launcher part where I put the spanners in on the side, but one block away. And I did buy two more Goliath drills and two more Davids, but I'm not going to be setting those up just yet. But I am going to try to not dig into the dirt. I accidentally placed a pipe down there in the dirt and I couldn't reach it. So I had to get my pickaxe and dig it out so I could pick it up. So we're gonna crack on and get a design going and hopefully get something that'll produce a little bit of gold for us, because I am almost completely broke. I think I left my money in the shop, but I think I have like 10,000 left. I think we spent all 110,000 gold that we had on the parts that you see here. Alright, so I grabbed some of these. We can use them as like stairs, it would be nice to just have everything designed to be enough for everything, so I don't have to mess around with it later. I think that'll work right there. So now we're gonna throw in all these filters, but I need them to have them backwards. Actually, because I don't know if that's gonna work either, because I forgot. I need to get the pipe in there. Okay, so that will work. I don't know if that's gonna mess up the dirt coming out. I hope not, but we'll run with that. All right, and I know having 5 of these is a little overkill for the filtering system. If I have the money for it, I might as well just throw them all in. All right, now let's throw in all the conveyor belts again. All right, so the gold is gonna be our first one here. Let's go ahead and figure out where I need to place this. See, I don't know if that's short enough. I think the dirt might get stuck on that bit right there. So I might need to lower this down one more. Whoa. Yep, so the gems are gonna be somewhere over here. All right, so I'm hoping now that if they shoot out, they're not gonna fly out past this. But I guess for now, let's just hook up this section. All right, let's go ahead and just grab our cart and move it over here. Yeah, I think we'll do a teapot right there. All right, so we do an angled one down there, an angled one right there. Let's go ahead and sleep. And then just for now, because I don't have the money, I'm gonna grab the non-powered pressure tank. And I'm gonna place it right here. I mean, hopefully I'll be able to still... Yeah, I should still be able to put an ingot in there. And then... right here... I want to put in a valve. Because I want to be able to turn this side off if I need to. Alright, because in order to expand this machine... I'm either gonna have to just put a T in back here... because I'd have 2 more Goliath drills in a line, so this pipe would need to move. Okay, let's just grab the cart. And I don't think I can jump over there. Oh, there we go, perfect. Okay. So I'm gonna switch this piece out. We're gonna throw in a T junction right there. We're gonna have it go down into another angled bit. Okay, this one's a powered filter. So this needs power facing. Yeah, I guess we're gonna have to do it that way. Okay, so I think water... Oh, I need to have water going into there too. I think it'd be best to branch it off from that one. All right, so another T piece. I don't know if I have another one in here. I sure hope I have enough pipe. All right, now let's hook up... Well, let's make sure everything, all the pipes are hooked up. I have it coming out here. We got one going into there, one going into this line. All right, because I probably need another power one right here. Or I guess it's not power. I don't know why I keep calling it power. It's just a pressure. The pressure chamber. All right, that way, hopefully this will give enough pressure to make this line a little bit faster. Well, I guess the thing way down here needs power, but we can set that up at the end. Because this is getting, it's getting a little messy right now, huh? Come on. There we go. Okay, let's go ahead and throw our ingots into there, because I'm pretty sure this is gonna be good to go now. So let's do a quick run through. I got the water coming into here. I have a main valve there to turn everything off. All right, we got an ingot in there, pipes going into everything. Yeah, so I do need to throw in the corks into everything. It's a convenient spot that I put them on the ground. All right, let's get some of this stuff out of the way. And let's do a test run real quick. All right, so we're just gonna throw the foundations in right here real quick. Let's go ahead, we can put that off to the side. I don't have quite enough money for these. These are like 17,000 a piece. So I can only afford one. All right, let's go ahead and turn everything on. Yeah, so the David is working. It threw some dirt out, which is nice. That is working. Let's see, I think I need to turn on. I need to turn on that. Okay, so that's working. This is the grinder. This should be working. There we go. Now it's working. Okay, these are going really slow. So that's not great. Let's see, is this powered? It is powered. The light's on. How long does it take? Oh, okay, there we go. Perfect. Alright. Gold went straight into there. You got some gems. Let's see, I guess just to test it, I don't think this is gonna work. I'm pretty sure the gems will get stuck right here. Oh, nice. They actually made it in there. Very cool. Alright, but there's no water going into there, so it's not gonna make a difference. Because I can't uncork it and throw this into there, because then this bar is gonna be in the way. This is gonna work, but now I have no way to turn that into an ingot. How did I do that before? Wait, was this a logic instead of water? This might be logic. I think that one's a logic input instead of the water. Yep, that would be it. Okay. So yeah, with that, we got the ingot over there. That proves that this system is working and it is functional. I didn't run it long enough to see if this is gonna work, but that'll be something I can change pretty easily. So in between episodes, we are going to be getting a lot more money so we can fill out this system a little bit more. I'll probably try to clean things up and get things a little bit more organized. I just wanted to get a good idea of how a system like this is going to be set up, and I think we did okay. There's a lot of things that I could change up to do a little bit differently. But yeah, thanks for watching. Like and subscribe if you enjoyed the content, and we will catch you in the next one.